Aloha ni, welcome to Tangata Pasifika. Tonight on the show, young Pacific people have their say in Parliament.
I'm actually glad that there are Pacific Islanders finally taking charge of what we've deserved from really the first place.
A mover and shaker in both the Pacific community and education.
Our challenge is to be relevant to New Zealand and to have a voice that really speaks to what Pacific women and families are saying.
And a CrossFit athlete wanting to be first in the world.
I just want to go there and try my best and see what I get placed.
But first to the capital and the earthquake that rocked the Marlborough and Wellington region on Sunday evening. Aftershocks continue to cause concern in those areas and many Wellingtonians are on edge. Tangalo Tele o Sone Okesene with this report.
Tuesday in the capital and it's back to work.
Back in the office today, again, it's business as usual.
But the weekend shake has left people on edge.
I don't think you can get back to normal. I think, you know, you are very much on edge.
You know, I brought my running shoes to work today because if I have to get home, I know I'm going to have to scramble.
A series of small earthquakes jolted the region for a few days. But the big one hit just after 5 p.m. on Sunday. A 6.5 earthquake centred in the Cook Strait. The town of Seddon in Marlborough is closest to the quake's epicentre. Locals are shaken, including a group of Pacific Island seasonal workers.
We were about to have our afternoon tea, and there was like aftershocks from last night, and there was this big earthquake, and we were all like running outside because it's stronger, very strong.
This shelter was set up soon after the quake. The workers were keen to spend the night here.
Back home, we experienced earthquakes, but not what we experienced this afternoon. And we ran out and there were cracks all over, so we have to find a place safe.
In the capital, families dashed to safety.
We got under the doorway and I could hear rattling in the kitchen, so I was thinking to myself, oh my gosh, it's serious, it's real.
Come Monday morning, there's damage along the waterfront and mostly superficial damage to some buildings. It's enough for officials to warn CBD workers to stay away for the day.
All the businesses, even bank, clothing store, everything has been closed.
By Tuesday, city officials were confident the CBD could get back to business.
There is no evidence of any structural damage to buildings in Wellington.
But being 12 floors up in the CBD isn't totally comforting. A quake on Friday more distressing for some than the bigger quake on Sunday.
When you're sitting about 12 floors up, you actually can feel the building sway. And probably that was the longest experience I've had with earthquakes.
While no lives were lost, ongoing aftershocks have many Wellingtonians uneasy of the big one.
Apparently, that's not the quake that was on the fault line that's going to give us the big one.
No, I don't think that's the big one. That was just a wake-up call.
In other news now, plans are well underway to mark this year's Maiwa Nui Constitution Festival in the Cook Islands with Akairata O Festival here in Auckland.
That's right. The week-long celebrations in August will culminate in a Cook Islands cultural festival at the Vodafone Event Centre in Manukau that's set to rival the one back in the islands. Here's John Utunga.
A winter dance practice for the Auckland Puekura community.
It's new in Auckland. It's the first time it's being held. Being part of the waka and rara, I think it's important.
They're one of five Cook Islands communities taking part in the dance competition at the end of a week-long celebration.
It makes them proud, and it's good. It brings everybody together. It's basically unity and coming together as a group. And I know it doesn't always happen pretty fast, but it does happen.
The festival's called Akirata O, the brainchild of CDANS, the Cook Islands community organisation tasked with raising the economic and social well-being of the community here in New Zealand, starting with Auckland.
Yeah, it's going well. It's tight, you know, we've gone into the festival lean, resource-wise, but, you know, first year's first, you know, there's always going to be some tight spots.
Last year, CDANS organised the first ever Cook Islands Community Awards and had a hand in launching Cook Islands Language Week. This year, Akirata O will feature the awards, Language Week, and a host of activities including a night market, products expo, and even baked goods. For organisers, it's another step in an action plan launched last year to mobilise the community.
The talk's over, time to work. I can tell you right now, a lot of the group have really put a lot of time and labour into this.
For many, the highlight of the week will be the cultural festival, modelled on the hugely successful Maivanui in Rarotonga. And leading the charge here is Kaumatua and cultural expert Te Poave Araitia.
For this year, as starters, we have decided to have only four categories. That's the ute, the imenetuki, urapau, and also the kaparima. Those four. We also included a, we call it a tangikara, and also a string band. But that is a choice outside of the main categories to be competed.
As well as Puaikura, groups representing Rarotonga's two other districts will also take part, as will the Mauke and Rakahanga communities. It's a welcome opportunity, especially for young Cook Islanders, many of whom take part in the annual school's Polyfest.
I think it's good for Auckland, you know, to bring us to close the gap between the festivals that we have for the high school colleges, and basically after that there is nothing. So it's important that we actually fill the gap, you know, carry on, continue the, you know, the culture festival on this side.
So it might not be Maivanui, but it's the next best thing.
Knowing that it's always done every year in Raro, and we can't really afford to go back every year, I think it's a good opportunity for us girls, younger girls, especially the ones who just left school. This competition is a good like wake-up call for our culture as well as our identity based here in Auckland. And it's a good way to socialise with other Cook Islanders.
Oh, looks like fun. Keep watching after the break. A Driven Pacifica leader.
It really is an honour to be chosen for that. Secondly, it's also a responsibility that whatever you've got, you serve in whichever way.
And Pacific Youth in Parliament.
I just had a bit of an anxiety attack, which is pretty bad.
Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. It's work experience like no other, the chance for students around the country to walk in the shoes of an MP for 2 days.
It's called Youth Parliament, and Sena Folava Sanele Chadwick was in Parliament to find out how these youth MPs were coping.
It's the hub of New Zealand politics. It's where our laws are passed and important decisions made by adults. But today the Beehive takes on a more youthful appearance. Students around the country are given the opportunity to be a youth MP. And for these guys, it's a chance of a lifetime.
Hey there, my name's Corey Foimono. I'm the deputy head boy over at Altair College, and I'm Jan Logie's youth MP.
Malo Elele, my name is Jacinta Taliuli, and I attend Manurewa High School, and I'm the youth MP for Manurewa.
Kia rana, my name is Ngāti Korima. I represent Alfred Ngaro National MP and I'm from Tamaki College.
But for Jake Lamcum, it's his first time to Parliament.
Yeah, how you feeling?
Nervous?
Yeah. What are you expecting when you walk in there? I'm
not really sure.
Yeah.
For the next 2 days, these three young MPs, along with 118 others, will get a taste of what it's like being a Member of Parliament. They'll get to participate in select committees, question time, and even partake in the debating chamber, as well as fielding questions from the media.
There's just so many things going on at the moment. I've got to say, Youth Parliament, even though it just started a couple of hours ago, it's really intense.
And it didn't take long for that intensity to show itself in the debating chamber when Kore Fuimono put a question to the Education Minister.
With the Nova Pay system and upgrade NCEA infrastructure compared with the amount to establish charter schools.
Mr Speaker, what a great question.
But Fuimono didn't think he was going to finish his question.
I just had a bit of an anxiety attack, which is pretty bad.
But there were no such nerves for Manurewa High School student Jacinta Taliauli, even though she wasn't sure what to expect in the Māori Affairs Select Committee.
Well, Māori Affairs wasn't originally my first choice, but I'm quite glad after looking at the question that it is something that relates to my community.
After listening intensely to the submission makers, Taliauli found common ground between her Pacific roots and tikanga Māori.
We should be focusing on preserving Māori language and Māori culture because it is something that matters to New Zealand.
But the highlight for most students is question time.
Lock the doors.
Lock the doors!
What percentage of the budget will be spent on boys and girls?
How will charter schools further improve a system that is already showing results and progress in this area?
Does it mean that you're inherently saying that your perspective on the meaning of democracy is one that excludes the basic right of freedom of speech?
Can I first start by saying how generous the Speaker of the House is in allowing all of these supplements?
Order, the Minister will just address the question.
The experience was eye-opening, especially for Tamaki College student Jake Lamcombe, who admits he wasn't a fan of politics before arriving in Wellington.
Ever since I've been here, I actually realised that the government actually, all the decisions they make actually affect me and the youth, and pretty much it's actually not boring, really, yeah, it's actually interesting.
For others, Youth Parliament has made them rethink what they will do when they leave secondary school.
Before coming to Youth Parliament, definitely set my eyes upon going down south to study film because it's one huge passion that I have. But now that I've done this, and I know some of my friends are out there thinking Corey just become a politician, so I might.
One thing these youth MPs do have in common is their drive to see more Pacific Islanders in Parliament.
There definitely has to be more representation of Pacific Islanders and Māori there. I don't think I'm seeing enough there. And it would be awesome to get, you know, their input and their views on all these issues around us.
I'm actually glad that there are Pacific Islanders finally taking charge of what we've deserved from really the first place.
And it's this passion and attitude that will be needed if these young Pacific Islanders are to return in a more official capacity in the next few years.
Time now for this week's notices with a track from Sol Brown featuring Yanisa, Don't Tell Me You Love Me. Don't you tell me, don't you
tell me you love me. Yes, I, right here, collaboration, Miss Yanisa and Sol Brown, Iman on your sound system.
Now the track Don't Tell Me You Love Me is available on iTunes and Amplifier. Okay, still to come, a leader in both the community and education.
If you can get our own people to look at issues from their own perspectives, then you should be able to make a better decision and it should result in a better outcomes for Pacific people.
And the pocket rocket that's off to the world champs.
Well, we'd hope that we can bring home a gold medal or a medal would be awesome.
Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. There's a new leader at the helm of this country's oldest Pacific women's organisation, Pacifica, which began back in 1976.
Tangalotele Professor Peggy Fairbairn Dunlop has been a strong advocate for women's issues for close to four decades, and she's been one of our biggest champions in the education field. Sandra Kailahi spoke to the professor about the two roles.
This is the newest branch of Pacifica. Manukau.
Welcome pioneers and welcome new fighters, if you like, for Pacifica women.
There was a city branch, very vibrant branch, over 100 members, and there's one at Tamaki, and that was all for Auckland. And I mean, if you come out here and look at South Auckland, it just seemed a natural thing.
The idea of women and Pacific women coming together, it didn't really matter whatever the purpose was going to be, I knew it would be good.
Because I'm a Pacifica Tongan. Woman here in New Zealand, so I just love to join in with anything to do with a Pacifica woman.
The branch is the organisation's 16th across the country and was officially launched to coincide with International Women's Day by the new president, Tangalotele Professor Peggy Fairbairn Dunlop.
It's bringing in women who work long hours, have children, have a passion or commitment for bettering Pacific quality of life, but also want a place where they can just sit and talk. So there's very much a social and unwinding bit about our meetings as well.
Tangaloa Tele joined the organisation in the late 70s. She stayed for a few years before moving to Samoa, staying away for 25 years. But in 2006, she came back and picked up where she left off. Earlier this year, she was elected president of Pacifica.
It really is an honour to be chosen for that. Secondly, it's also a responsibility that whatever you've got, you serve in whichever way, and something that I can make a contribution to.
Now the challenge is to take the long-standing traditional organisation and make it relevant in this day and age.
We're a different organisation today from what we were 30 years ago. We've got a whole group of absolutely fantastic women, and we're not using their strengths and their knowledge to better the lives of Pacific families in New Zealand today. Our challenge is to be relevant to New Zealand and to have a voice that really speaks to what Pacific women and families are saying. It's not just the issues, it's really the friendships, the networks, and the looking after each other as women and sharing our hopes and dreams as well. So that's important. So if you stand back a bit and look at it again, do you think we're going to be able to change, to go back to...
It's also a dream for Peggy to increase the number of Pacific postgraduate students at the Auckland University of Technology. It's one of the other hats she wears. She's the only Pacific professor at AUT, and she's passionate about helping students and Pacific research.
It's to get the fullest picture before you make a decision. Just looking at one Palangi viewpoint, that's fine, that's one viewpoint, but if you can get our own people to look at issues from their own perspectives, then you should be able to make a better decision, and it should result in a better outcomes for Pacific people.
Professor Fairbairn Dunlop has her hands full. She's on different boards and committees, but her role as Pacifica president and her work at AUT go hand in hand for the betterment of Pacific people in this country.
She inspires a lot of women, both in Samoa, the Pacific region, and she's somebody who's really on about promoting and uplifting the Pacific talent there is.
She's really passionate about working with women and seeing Pacifica women grow and be all that we can be.
We've got lots of Pacific people on the rugby fields and the arts, and that's where our students and our children tend to be looking. But if we can get Pacific people right across the education sphere and decision-making spheres as well as the models for the next generation, but also as impacting on decision-making, then that's what life should be about.
To sports now, CrossFit is world-renowned as a grueling test for the world's toughest athletes since it began in the USA in the early 2000s.
Yes, it's got a massive following in Aotearoa, but obviously not by us. And a young Tongan athlete from Gisborne is attempting to make her mark internationally, competing this week in the CrossFit Games in California. John Pulu decided to put her to the test.
She's tough, she's fierce, and she's got the muscles to prove it. The thing is, she's just 12 years old. Trinity Lolohe isn't your ordinary 12-year-old who likes to play dress-up, paint her nails, or listen to Justin Bieber. She plays with some big toys.
Stand up tall. Doing well, the ladies.
I enjoy that I can work out with, like, my friends and my family, yeah, and have fun and try to beat them.
You're already lost. Keep going, Ash. Get all your power.
This young Tongan Māori athlete is part of an exercise phenomenon called CrossFit. It combines cardio, weights and gymnastics all into one. Phew, I'm tired just thinking about it. But unlike me, thousands worldwide have followed the fitness craze. It currently stretches out to over 6,000 gyms around the world. Now it's crossed over to New Zealand and it's big here in Gisborne.
Well, my mum, she got a job here, you know, Renee.
Awesome, nice work. Keep going, guys.
And she's just like, oh, this will be cool. So she signed me up and I enjoyed it.
Girls on the wall balls, we have a little look at technique.
That's right, mum Renee is right by her side. She's Trinity's personal trainer.
I was blown away at how good she was. I was thinking, oh my goodness, this year. And just her drive. She just kept going. She'd look at me every now and then. I could see in her eyes, she's thinking, I've got nothing left, and I just say to her, hey, babe, just keep going, you're nearly there, and she'd just keep going.
It's that very push that's helped Trinity qualify earlier this year at the CrossFit Gauntlet competition in Hawke's Bay. She was announced second in the world for her age group.
Better, guys. Nice straight arms, Trin. Straight arms.
And like any reporter worth their salt, I put my body on the line to find out how tough she actually is.
OK, Trinity, what's next?
We're going to do a kipping chin-up.
Cool. Show me how to do it. Trinity, I'll show you how it's really done. All right, Trinity, what are we doing now?
Well, now we're doing wall balls. Oh,
this is really heavy.
That's the ladies.
I knew that.
John! We're doing knee snaps now.
All right, sorry. I was just praying. I'm still struggling because I got a ping pong injury, so it's tough.
Excuses, excuses. I admit it, I was beaten by a 12-year-old. She's too good.
She's tough. Look up to the horizon. Looking up.
And now the Americans want her. Well, not to keep, but to compete in California against the very best from around the world.
As soon as we heard, I was like, we're going. I don't know how or I don't care how we're going. And then my husband Bela was just like, well, if you want to go, then this is the amount of money you need to make. And I just thought, okay, we're going to do it.
It's going to be a costly exercise to get Trinity to the USA. She has to raise around $10,000, and her community is right behind her, fundraising using fitness.
I can't put it into words when you see people helping you out for your daughter or you know, a goal that you've had for your family, and especially your daughter's going to represent.
Tonight the community have turned out in their fitness gears for a bit of Zumba, but they're not just here to work up a sweat, they're also here to donate.
CrossFit has brought a community together, and now they're moving in unison to make Trinity's dreams become a reality.
Well, we'd hope that we can bring home a gold medal, or a medal would be awesome, but just definitely want to make sure Trinity gives her best so that we're representing Gisborne and our community and even New Zealand.
I just want to go there and try my best and see what I get placed.
Oh my gosh, I'm speechless.
Way to go, Trinity. I'm sure she's going to bring home gold this time.
Go hard. All right, we've got a new Samoan language resource for your kids.
And that's Tom acting there in that little Muppet. We've just got two to give away. Just go to our website for details. And while you're there, you can catch our stories and find out what's happening in the community online at tvnz.co.nz. Keyword Tangata Pasifika. On Facebook, just like us. And we're on YouTube as well.
All right, we leave you now with King Kapisi's new video clip, Crush, Soifua.
Tohani. Rocker from Dilated Peoples, Tena Moana, shout outs to Jerome Kano and Shay Fu, yo. Let's go. We won't crush everything like a weapon we bring. Number front of no thing when we step on this thing. I recite your sick kingdoms for plantation ring. All the people like you feeling all right. We won't crush everything like a weapon we bring. Number front of no thing when we step on this thing. I recite your sick kingdoms for plantation ring. All the people like you feeling all right. Fire dance and melt your wax like candles. My Uso stampede to advance their handle. Be your cap spitted like some rap monster ramble. Schwarzenegger shot cops and killed in commando. But I just keep it luau status. I'm going with wild Samoans like I'm luau Bando. Island mom, you don't wanna surf our channels. I don't sing, but I'm high as a new soprano. Crocodile lady, Golden State high stated. They don't wait it with fiends, get extreme for ice skating. Gamble with the mic, you can get your dice taken. Hip hop lives here, don't get your life taken. That Ula Pakalolo hero will give thanks to the heavens from the earth below. Islanders worldwide, CA to New Zealand, you taught it a rock, so let's catch. We won't crush everything like a weapon.